For f of x equals 2x, what is the translation and new function for g of x equals f of x minus 1? So what we're doing is we're taking 1 away from the inputs. So here we'll make g of x equals f of x minus 1. So we're taking 1 away from the inputs. So really what we're doing here is here's our 2, and we're taking x minus 1 first. So you're taking 1 away from the x, and then you're multiplying by 2. And that's what this f of x minus 1 means. The other way to write it would be with a negative 1 outside like this. That would be g of x equals 2x minus 1. But if it was f of x minus 1 like that, you would have closed parentheses here and not out here. So this is not the situation. This is what we're doing here. And you could simplify this if you wanted to. You could say g of x equals 2x minus 2 by distributing. It doesn't really help in this situation because it really clouds the issue of the transformations, but these functions are equivalent. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and graph. And I'm going to graph f of x or y equals 2x. And then I'm going to graph 2 and then open parentheses x minus 1. And let's graph both of those. Okay, now notice the transformation here. The graph has moved over one to the right. And remember, blue is the function f of x equals 2x, and the red is the g of x, which is the 2, and then times parentheses x minus 1. And it shifted one to the right. And that's what happens when you take one away from the inputs. Okay, so the translation is right 1. And our function is g of x equals 2 times parentheses x minus 1. And just to clarify the point, you really don't want to do what I did here and distribute the 2 because it really confuses about the transformations. You want to leave in this original form here, and then you can easily analyze the transformations.